Well, there are some April Fool's jokes out there that are so convincing that people actually get tricked.
And others, not so much. Matt King takes a look at some of the year's best pranks.
Samsung's pigeon-powered universal Wi-Fi.
Introducing Schuber X.
Sony's delicious power food cake mix.
Redbox told us its new color-changing console would match our mood. Twitter announced the invention of the Twitter helmet. And Kodak introduced its new picture kiosk drone. None of these devices actually exist. All found us on April 1st via the internet.
The biggest problem with the internet at times is the internet itself.
Silverback Social CEO Chris Dessi joined us through Skype, a service that did not try to punk us this April Fool's Day, unlike seemingly every other somewhat hip company.
So now you can plug in?
Sony claimed it invented a way to convert human food into a power source for electronic devices. Toms and Uber teamed up to create a promo video for Schuber, cars without wheels. And Samsung vowed to use pigeons to bring free Wi-Fi to the city of London.
We have learned that if you can get pigeons to congregate, you get really strong Wi-Fi.
They do put money behind it, they do put time and effort behind it, and it results in something that's really fun, really playful, and highly effective as a marketing tool on behalf of these clients.
If many of those clients seem to deal in new technologies, Dessi says that makes sense.
They live and die by how cool they are perceived to be.
And an ad displaying a giant brand's sense of humor helps to humanize that brand, making even the largest corporation seem cool.
There are people that wait all year to see what Google is going to do on April Fool's Day.
And indeed, Google owns April Fool's Day trickery.
Fancy gentleman, cut a rug.
It debuted an emoji translator, a Pokemon mapping system, and at least 12 other pranks this April Fool's Day alone. But because Google counts on its users to reveal its hijinks, even more internal capers may exist undiscovered. On the Upper East Side, I'm Matt King, Fox 5 News.